Hello, welcome to Rad Exchange. My name is Craig Dial, and I'm going to be talking to you about maximizing your cone beam CT. We want to get the most out of our images, and I'm here to help you with that. I'm a dental radiographic technologist in Sacramento, California, and been using cone beam for quite some time. And we're going to talk about different things that affect your images. There's lots of options that can help improve your image quality. Resolution we're going to focus on calibration, signal, noise, motion artifact, voxel size, and software settings. Today, we're going to talk about calibration. I think calibration is one of the easiest ways you can improve the image quality of your CT scans. Cone beam CT units need tuning or calibration routinely. And you should look into your manuals and see whether or not your machine requires bi-monthly, monthly, weekly, or even daily calibrations. We have several different machines from different manufacturers, and some require a daily calibration, while others are longer periods. But it really is a great way to help improve your image quality without having to do much work. And why calibrate? I asked this to some of the engineers that build cone beam CTs, so I understand it better. Well, they tell me the calibration directly impacts the image quality. And when a properly calibrated machine is aligned, it produces images that are sharper, cleaner, less noise, and more accurate. So why not do a routine calibration? You may do a routine oil change in your car, to keep things all lubed up correctly, and calibration is similar, where we want to keep things tuned up to the best quality. And I get to see cone beam CTs from beam meters all over the country, even over the world, and often I get cases that have improper calibration, such as this grossly poor calibration that was set up. I think a head positioner was used in this scan. But sometimes there's minor, small calibration issues that we don't really see and pick up these small nuances. We get these little waves in the scan. And that's where the calibration errors can come in, and we can really affect the quality of what we're doing when things start not working out correctly. And if you have a scan where the data is corrupted, it might be a calibration issue. So the more that you calibrate, then the cleaner your scan is gonna be. And these are just some cases that I've received over time. Some of them have even ones in our own offices where we've made mistakes. But as you can see, if your scan's got noise introduced into it, a calibration is something that can easily fix it. This is just some edges of the scan affecting the quality of the overall picture. And sometimes the calibration even has a pretty looking, artsy looking picture to it. But other times, like I said, it's very subtle. And you can see there's rings on this scan. If you look closely, they're in every projection, and it's a calibration issue. So the point is, calibrate routinely. Sometimes the computer will have a line of dead pixels on the sensor, and this is a calibration issue. Calibrating routinely will turn those dead pixels off, and you won't see that line in your images. Other times, if you calibrate with something in the field of view, such as the head positioner, you'll get that white or that black line going across the image. So all these things are calibration issues and can be eliminated by improving your image quality by just that one task. So a geometric calibration is something that the manufacturer can help you with. And this is usually a cylinder that goes into your machine. Some manufacturers provide a cylinder for you, or they might have the tech come in and use the cylinder calibration. And this particular calibration tool extracts mechanical dimensions of the machine, such as the source to imager distance, the source to center of rotation, and the central ray rotation. These things help improve more calibration. This is something that the scan has produced more calibration noise. Just how you can see, there's so many different cases that it could be affected by. And then other calibration notes, extreme temperature variation could affect your image quality, such as very hot or too cold. If you have an office that might be in a hot part of the climate of the country, and it starts out cool in the morning, but then you have a window that's the scanner sitting next to, and the sun bakes onto the sensor, and it becomes an extremely hot temperature variation, that can affect your image quality. Electronic noise in the sensor will be different than room temperature. This is from the engineers. If you calibrate in these conditions, extreme hot or cold, it's best to recalibrate when normal conditions are apparent. So if your machine is next to a window, for an example, and there's extreme temperature variations, it doesn't hurt to calibrate once in the morning and once after lunch. And they tell me the two things that greatly affect calibration is if the machine's being bumped hard or extreme change in temperature. You have a patient that hits your machine, you might want to recalibrate after that. There's other calibration notes that you need to be aware of. You can do an in-house calibration test, such as a Coke can. Coca-Cola tries very hard to make sure their cans are a cylindrical 66.04 millimeters. And when you do a scan, you want to make sure that you have a cylindrical scan. So you take a can of Coke, you put it in your machine, and that measures the 66.04, and you want to make measurements around that circular area to make sure that you have a cylindrical, accurate calibration. That's all I'm going to talk about for calibration today. I hope that you do it routinely. Please look in your manual for your particular calibration needs for your particular machine. Thank you for logging in to RadExchange.